Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mark McCartney. You might know me better as XPCReaper, and I am one of three content producers for Trojan Horse Gaming. Of course, I'm a PC exclusive these days, and I'm currently working on the library card series, but just wanted to give you a sort of indication of what goes into recording an episode of the library card, or indeed any episode which we put up on YouTube, for example Minecraft. So you might be able to see directional microphones. I always like to have a proper audio setup on everything. When I record on the PC for solo commentaries, I use a large diaphragm condenser mic. These ones are small diaphragm directional ones, both of which are Behringer. I use the Behringer C4 series for the unidirectional, or for multidirectional large diaphragm, I use the Behringer C1. For an audio interface, of course, again, I use Behringer equipment. I'm running a Zenix 1222 USB mixer, and I record all of my audio through it, since I run microphones directly into it, and I decided to run my PC into the 2-track, which is just standard phono leads. You might be able to see, sneaking around behind me, is the lovely Morris McAuleen. And he was just moving my water, which of course, you know, water is very important. And now he's making a racket climbing back over the sofa. I think we can probably edit that part out, or not. Apparently we're keeping it in. So, what games do I play? Primarily, admittedly, I'm a Warhammer 40,000 fan. I play both the Space Marine third-person action games and the Dawn of War real-time strategy series ones. But I also play a wide variety of other games. Call of Duty Ghosts, for example, I've played a fair bit of. Battlefield 4, I've also got a few hours sunk into it. Then, of course, we've got other games. I like to experiment with other ones. Space Pirates and Zombies is one which has been coming up a lot on my Steam library, and Arma 3 for just for a helicopter flying in it. I like to fly a helicopter, feel like a pilot, that sort of stuff, you know. Mustache has a lovely little smile there. So yeah, where do I get my PC games? Either Steam sales, which admittedly have taken more than I care to admit of my money, or there are three main websites I use as well. There is indiegala.com, which is a bit like humblebundle.com, which I also use. They're both bundles, pay what you want. And then there's also a third one called Bundle Stars, which I use, which gives you preset game bundles, and it's usually less than £3 for the bundle. Sometimes it ranges from as little as £1.50 up to maybe £4. But for the quality of games you get, I feel those are my three favourites. In terms of AAA releases, I usually use either G2A.com or fast2play.com. Fast2, that's to the number. And the reason I use both of those is because they're just cheaper. Third-party retailer websites I always prefer to use. Of course, in the videos I give you the pricing of games available on Steam. However, those ones are not the only ones. Feel free to shop around. I always endorse people spending as little money as possible, because I'm a little bit stingy myself. Everyone's got a budget, not everyone can spend £40 on a brand new game. And I'm trying to think if there are any other ones. I've got a couple of games which I purchased off Uplay.com during some of their sales. Amazon.com, I've bought a couple of their boxed bundles.
Origins.
I have used Origins once, in fact. Only once, and that was to purchase Command & Conquer The Ultimate Collection, which was £12.49. For 17 Command & Conquer games, like 17 including all the expansions, of course, £12.49 for me was a pretty decent deal. I didn't mind spending that much. That's the only thing I've actually purchased from them. I've got a few games on Origin, but of course I got them from the Humble Origin bundle, which is probably as close to buying from Origin as I will ever get. In terms of recording videos, I use DXTory, or DXTory, I'm still not sure how it's pronounced or whatever, but it's one that I feel is better than Fraps. It's definitely less performance intensive than Fraps, because if I record a game at 30 frames per second, I don't get frame drops where it's down to 12 frames per second while I'm playing. Instead, it actually records up to 120 frames per second, but since we're producing videos for YouTube, 30 frames per second, of course, all of their videos get dropped down to, so recording in 60 wouldn't really make much sense. I set it so that I've got the speaker audio, which runs in for one of them, and that's one of the channel inputs. Of course, I adjust game volume in post. And then for the actual commentary, I set it so that it's running the USB audio codec for my Behringer mixer, which I use for all my recording. And I'm not a fan of Fraps, to be honest, unless they implement some kind of way of interfacing DXTory with Call of Duty Ghosts. I doubt I will be bringing footage of it. There are some games which just won't interface with DXTory for some obscure reason, and those games I would rather not produce, because I feel that the quality would be dropped down too low. You would have significantly lower frame rate and all, and unless I can produce the best quality content I possibly can, I won't want to produce it, because it wouldn't feel right to me as a producer, and it wouldn't be right to you as the actual viewers to have to watch low quality entertainment. The reason I put entertainment in air quotes is, frankly, I don't find any of my shit entertaining. But for Moustache has a cold or something at the moment, and of course, if everyone wants to leave a little comment saying "get well soon, kiss kiss Moustache,"
right,
not XX, don't put XX. No, I want to see kiss kiss in those comments, because that man works really hard for the channel. Even if some of the descriptions for the videos, such as Operation Flashpoint, don't reflect it.
What were they doing there?
Moustache doesn't realise what he did here. I put up the Operation Flashpoint video, and the description of it. Oh no, you didn't copy it. Oh wait, yeah, you actually did. There's a conversation for the description between me and Moustache about how I burned my tongue on a cup of tea.
That was intentional.
He says it's intentional. It's intentional, ladies and gentlemen.
I responded to it.
I'm aware you did. I couldn't help but look at it and be like, okay, that's absolutely genius, but also at the same time, stupid. So, of course, ladies and gentlemen, if you see conversations or just the descriptions for our videos, just, you know, go with it. Go with it. When it comes to producing content, I have a very simple way of doing things. Firstly, I like to produce a notepad document with the developer and publisher of the game in question, if I'm doing a library card, of course. If I'm not, then I just produce the video itself. But for library cards, of course, developer and publisher, I include the aggregate Metacritic scores, some of the developer or publisher's other titles, and the price as its normal sale price on Steam. I never include third-party retailers or Steam sales, because of course both of those are impermanent, and third-party retailers can run out of stock quite quickly. I have on many occasions went to a third-party retailer, looked to purchase the game, and it wasn't in stock. So I feel it's best for me to include the normal sale price on Steam, but I never say that's what you should pay for it. I endorse people looking for deals, of course, and trying to find the game as cheaply as possible. When it comes to ideas for producing content, such as the library card, I like to think, what kind of content do I enjoy producing? Which of course is gameplay commentaries and reviews. And then I also think, what is the best way I can do this? So, if you buy a game, for example, which I have recommended, you're buying that on my impressions of the game in a short amount of time. There will be some games where I have a significant amount of time sunk into them, but on those occasions, I will actually mention that. First impressions for me are critical. It's the same with food, it's the same with music. If something doesn't get you in the first half an hour of a video game, for example, odds are you won't enjoy the rest of it. You don't want to sit through 2.5 hours of boring gameplay in order to get to the real stuff, because you won't have the patience. So I like to produce from the very start of a game, or at least mention that I've skipped an hour, maybe 2 hours of gameplay of it. And that's basically where my ideas for library card have come from. Commentaries, I record on the fly. The Operation Flashpoint, for example, it was recorded as a post one. Normally I like doing live commentary, but I had to do... I'm not good at catching. Operation Flashpoint, of course, was one that I produced and uploaded. The first time I looked at the game and said, okay, this is a slightly boring first-person shooter. Then when I realized it had overwritten my codex and it hadn't recorded my commentary on it, I was like, okay, this is slightly irritating, I'll mention it. By the third time, I had played maybe 1 hour of the game, and in that 1 hour, I was bored. That 1 hour of gameplay was more than I could actually stomach, to the point where I became extremely negative in the review of the game. Why? Because if a game is entertaining half an hour in, but not in the first half an hour...
Oops.
We're gonna have to do this again.
That's okay, don't worry.
Hot dogs, though.
We got interrupted, so now we're eating hot dogs.
Yep. As you know, I'm a fan of staying hydrated. I always like to keep water near me during videos. Apparently, I also keep hot dogs near me, which I don't actually. But hot dogs are hot dogs. It's food. So in terms of the specifications for the PC I use, I've got a custom one, which I built myself. It uses an Orion CIT gaming case, which it comes with an inbuilt fan to the side. Of course, since I'm out in the garage, this room is the same temperature as outside most of the time, since I don't record with any form of heating on because it would be too noisy. Cooling in that case is, it's just ambient cooling, really. In terms of the motherboard, I use a Gigabyte F2A55m-DS2 series, which is a FM2 socket PCI Express 3.0. It doesn't support USB 3.0, it's only USB 2.0, but it does have SATA 3.0, which is basically what I need. And for hard drives, I run my operating system off of a MAXTOR 320GB. I could tell you a serial number if I looked it up, but I forget. And it's just a very simple SATA MAXTOR 320GB. I also installed all of my programs like DXTory and just anything I use which isn't gaming or video, I produce on the C drive. For my D drive, which I install my games on, I've got a Western Digital 2TB hard drive, which is SATA 3.0, and I record all of my videos onto a Seagate Barracuda 2TB one, which is also SATA 3.0. It originally was part of an external hard drive case, but of course those ones can just be opened up to remove the drive in question. Just standard 3.5 or 2.5 SATA in most cases. And for processor, I use an AMD X4-760K series, which is a quad-core processor clocked at 3.9 GHz. It gives me very good performance on everything. There are processors out there on the market which are better. There are some which are worse. But for me, the AMD X4-760K was just the right price. And it was just the right performance I was looking for. In terms of RAM, I have 8GB of Crucial BALLISTIX series memory, which I use in 2 4GB cards. And of course, the motherboard only supports 2 slots, so I could in future upgrade, but before I upgrade RAM, I would rather upgrade my motherboard as well, so that it can support FM2 series, or maybe AM3 if I upgrade the processor as well. And yeah, 8GB does well enough for me. It covers all games, it covers my recording. The only things it would be slow on would be rendering, of course, is slightly... It's not the fastest, of course, because it's only 8GB of RAM and a quad-core 3.9GHz, but for half an hour of footage, it takes about 2 hours to render in 1920x1080. For the graphics card I use, that's the most important bit of a gaming PC, I use an XFX AMD Radeon HD 7950. Is it a Radeon or Radeon? I can't remember. But it's a 3GB graphics card, GDDR5. It works perfectly for me. I bought it because it was £205 when I bought it on retail. It's probably gone down in price now. But it also came with Crysis 3, Tomb Raider, and... Oh wait, it was Crysis 3, Bioshock Infinite, and Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon. All of those I thought were like icing on the cake. It's like 3GB graphics card, which comes with free games. Yes please. So I went for that. Trying to think, what else do we have on my PC? For the power supply, I use a CoolerMaster GX 750W power supply unit. It's got the PCI Express graphics card power supply, which you need for high-end graphics cards nowadays. If you don't have one of those, you're essentially buying a big, expensive, unpowered block to put in your PC. But it also provides a variety of SATA power cables. It's got Molex power cables, which of course I use for some of the fans on the PC, and if I ever want to put LEDs onto the case to make it shiny, I can do that. Well, this has been a little showcase of the recording setup I use, and of course if you have any questions about the specifications of the PC, which will be in the description, then you can feel free to ask those in the comments section below. You can also ask any question you like about what way I record if you're unclear on anything, or maybe if you just want to suggest a series or a video which you feel would be enjoyable, feel free to leave a comment below. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.